did not last. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Meghna and today I'm going to be swatching and reviewing for you guys the Nykaa All Day Matte Waterproof, Transfer Proof, Mask Proof 12-Hour Liquid Lipstick. That's quite a mouthful. I know a lot of terms. I think whatever the claims are by the website are just mentioned in the name itself, so you know that it's got like everything, like all in one kind of a deal. So as you can see, I'm not wearing any concealer today. I'm not wearing anything except for my moisturizer. I'm completely barefaced because honestly, I was too lazy. I didn't have the time and the sun was going down. So I really didn't have the time to put on any concealer or do any sort of makeup. So you can see that I'm barefaced. Alright, so these lipsticks come in 10 different shades and I've got all 10 of them. So without any further ado, let's just begin with the swatches. Called Super Mom, and this is a orangey brown sort of shade. It does kind of wash me out. It is going to wash out deeper skin tone as well, but I think it's going to look quite well on fair to medium dark, not medium dark, but like fair to medium skin tones. Not a fan because it's warm toned, makes my teeth look yellow. It's just an orangey nude, okay, like not an orangey brown as such, but like a warm orangey nude is how I would describe this shade on me. Okay, it might look different on other people, but on me this is how it looks like. This second shade is called Darling Daughter and this is more like a corally nude. As you can see, the first shade was more like a burnt orange, like an orangey nude, and this one is more neonish, like more corally nude. It obviously does not suit me. It washes me out like massively, and again I feel like this shade is meant for fair to medium skin tones and not dusky skin tones. So yeah, this was the shade Darling Daughter. This third shade is called Dear Dog and this is a very pretty a rusty brown shade, I would say. Like it's warm toned and it's more like, it's quite like a rusty brownie orangey kind of shade. It is really pretty. It does suit me. It does not wash me out or anything like that. If you're looking for something like this, like a terracotta shade, you know, for like an everyday office wear kind of a thing, then this is a very nice shade. Obviously I don't really prefer this kind of shades because they are warm toned, but if you're looking for something like this, then definitely go for this one. So this was the shade Dear Dog. This fourth shade is called Soul Sister and this is a very nice pinky nude. I feel this is how the liquid version of Maybelline Touch of Spice should have been. Very pretty pinky nude. I don't think I need a lip liner with this. Very subtle, very nice. You can see the difference between all four shades. This was more orangey, corally, a rusty terracotta sort of shade. This one is pinky nude, but it has more like it has kind of like this mauve undertones to it, you know, like I'm not sure if you can see in the camera, but it has a slight bit of like mauve undertones to it, like a subtle deeper mauve kind of shade. I don't know if I'm really making sense, but yeah, I'm doing the best I can. And obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. I feel it looks really pretty on my dusky complexion at least. And if you're looking for a pinky nude, I think this is very nice. So yeah, this was the shade Soul Sister. This fifth shade is called Girl Gang. And I think on the Nykaa website, this is described as a berry shade. It is kind of a berry shade, but it is more like, you know, not like a bold berry shade. It's more like a subtler berry shade, if you know what I mean. Like it's a subtler version of a berry shade. Nevertheless, it looks quite pretty on me. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. I think on fair to medium skin tones, this is going to look like a dark berry, like a bolder berry sort of. But dusky skin tones, it looks more like a subtle berry. I do really like the shade. It's very pretty. So yeah, this is the shade Girl Gang. This 6 shade is called Grand Fan, and this is a very light baby pink sort of shade. Obviously, it does wash me out. I feel like I need to line my lips. But I think it's going to look really pretty on fair to medium skin tones, not even the medium dark skin tones. I think just fair to medium skin tones, it's going to look really pretty. On me also, it looks kind of nice, but it does wash me out. This is more like a cool toned pink, like if you tone down a fuchsia pink, like to be very, 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 very light, and then this is what you're going to get. So yeah, this is the shade Grand Fan. This next shade is called Dream Wife, and this is a very nice pink shade. It's a cool toned pink shade. It looks really pretty on me. I especially like these kind of pink shades. It's so difficult, I feel, to find a nice truly pink shade on, you know, dusky skin tone, because I feel most of our lips are kind of pigmented, so when you apply them, they kind of tend to look magenta or purplish pink sort of shade. But this one looks really nice, like a real true pink shade. I really like this one. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones, obviously. So if you're looking for a pink shade, definitely do check this one out. Very, very, very pretty. So yeah, this was shade A Dream Wife. This bright shade is called Teacher Tribe, and this is a very bright magenta shade. I feel like this looks like the Sugar Cosmetics Smudge Me Not in the shade Wine and Shine. I feel like this is a very nice dupe for that. So let me just check, because I do have a mini of the Wine and Shine lippy. So I'm just going to swatch it right here and see. Okay, it's not a dupe. So no, it's obviously not a dupe. Like the Wine and Shine lippy is more darker and more purpley, and this one, Teacher Tribe, is more pinky toned. So it's not really a dupe, but then it looks really similar. Okay, it actually looks really similar, and it looks so pretty. It's such a bright shade. I mean, such a pretty bright shade. Definitely, I'm telling you, if you like bold shades, definitely check this one out. I don't really think I have anything that looks like this, any shade that looks like this. A very pretty, very nice, absolutely amazing shade. So yeah, this was the shade A Teacher Tribe. This shade is called Cool Cop, and in no way do I think like this is a bright red shade. This is more like a rusty red shade. Honestly, not really a fan of this kind of shades. Very warm tone makes your teeth look yellow. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones, but rusty red shade, okay. Rusty red shade, not a bright red shade, not a true red shade, very warm rusty red shade. Not really my cup of tea. But it will suit obviously all skin tones, and if you are looking for a rusty orangey red shade, then you could go for this one. So yeah, this was the shade Cool Cop. This last shade is called Boss Babe, and this is a very nice, very beautiful deep red. I would say like a deep red berry shade. I know that on the website it is described as a deep red, but I feel on my lips it looks more like a deep red berry, like, you know, red berry as in like little bit of pink tones are to it. I'm not sure if you'll be able to catch it on camera, but it does have pink tones to it. But don't get me wrong, nevertheless, it's a very beautiful shade. If you like bold shades like me, then I mean, you're absolutely going to love this shade. I feel it's quite unique also, you know, it's a red berry shade, so I feel like very unique. It's not like a deep red, or not like a deep pink, or not like a deep berry even. It's more like a deep red berry shade. Very, very unique. I actually really, really, really love this shade. Very unique, really pretty. You can see I don't even think I need to apply any makeup, because the attention directly goes to my lips, because it makes my complexion look so bright. Love this shade, absolutely freaking love the shade. Also, keep in mind, it's a deep red berry shade. It's not a deep red shade, but it is extremely beautiful. Even if you buy this thinking that it would be a deep red shade and it turns out like it's not a deep red shade, you will not regret your decision of buying it. It's truly, truly beautiful. Definitely check this one out. So that was it for the swatches, you guys. Now for my review. First and foremost, these lipsticks retail for 349 rupees for 2.1 ml of product, which I feel is little bit less than what you usually get for that kind of price point. Like for 350, say you get, usually you get I think 2.5 or 3 ml ka product, but this one is little less. Next, they are cruelty free, paraben free, and they are vegan. Obviously, good thing. All of those things are good things. So next, let's check out the claims. So what they say is it's an all day matte formula. So I mean, obviously it's a matte formula, that's fine. 12 hours lasting. I would say this claim is completely untrue, because I tried this lipstick yesterday and it did not last me even one meal. Also, if you're in the habit of licking your lips quite a lot, then I would say it would not even last like 12 minutes on your lips, because it's just gonna fade off from the center. Like, you do that, because like if you do things like that quite often, then it's gonna just go from here. Can you see? It's gone already. See, it's fading already. So it's not going to last. So this 12 hour thing is very untrue, I feel. Like, as my experience at least, it has been very untrue. It did not last 12 hours. I don't think it lasted even 2 hours. So yeah, so that's quite disappointing, because that is like the major claim, like 12 hours ka claim they have. Anyways, so they are waterproof and transfer proof. Yeah, they are waterproof. And you can see that they are transfer proof as well. This is like very basic liquid lipstick claims. Next, they say that they are mask proof and smudge proof. So yeah, if they are transfer proof and smudge proof, then obviously they would be mask proof. Let me see if they are smudge proof. So you can see no smudges, so they are smudge proof. Next, they are saying that they are non-drying. This is absolutely untrue, at least in my case, because they are quite drying. Like, you would need like to apply a lip balm underneath if you want to apply these lipsticks, otherwise these lipsticks can be drying. They say that they are not drying because they are enriched with hydrating ingredients such as vitamin E and almond oil, but as I said, in my case it was untrue. They are quite drying, like not extremely drying, not like ultra drying, but they are quite drying. Okay, next they say that it is one stroke application. This is true for the darker shades of the lipstick. Like, if you see the lighter shades, these two shades and this one, this was I think Grand Fan or something, this one and these two shades, these lighter shades were quite streaky. They did not have like a one swipe pigmentation, so I think, but that's quite common with you know, lighter shades, I feel. Now, the things that I don't like is, first of all, the lasting power, not 12 hours. So I don't like that they don't really last very long. Even after one meal, it's going to go off from the center of your lips. Secondly, the thing that I don't like is that they take quite a hot minute to dry. Like, once you apply them, you have to just like fan them, like give them some air to dry up if you are in a hurry or anything. Then the third thing that I did not like is that they can be quite a bit drying. So if you have if you have lines on your lips, then they tend to like exaggerate the lines. Like, you can see over here, they tend to like exaggerate the fine lines. Actually, you cannot see with this shade because this shade is so bright and bold, so you can't really make out. But if you go for some of the nude shades, then you will be able to see it very clearly, that it exaggerates the fine lines on your lips. I think those are the only three things that I did not like in this lipstick. That was it, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.